The late 19th century was a dynamic and exciting time in American history, a time of great innovation and even greater opportunity. The Industrial Revolution gave rise to vigorous new industries. Manufacturing, railroads, and communications were all booming. And in the process, a small group of Americans became incredibly wealthy. They were the entrepreneurs of the age, men of wealth and vision who made their huge fortunes seemingly overnight. At a time when the median family income was less than $500 a year, these industrial titans made tens of millions, fortunes which today would be worth billions. All this during a time when there was no personal income tax. This new class of millionaires spent freely and extravagantly, causing Mark Twain to cynically dub this the Gilded Age.
And what lay underneath was not particularly attractive in many cases. A lot of these fortunes were made in ways that didn't bear a lot of scrutiny. A lot of these people came from backgrounds that were not particularly illustrious. So there was a gilding, a patina put over one's past.
And the era's nouveau riche saw themselves as America's nobility. They built magnificent estates, palaces really, that rivaled those in Europe. Architectural extravagance became a hallmark of the Gilded Age. And nowhere was this more elaborately realized than in the small seaside mecca of high society known as Newport, Rhode Island. Here along the seaside on exclusive Bellevue Avenue were some of the most opulent homes ever built in America. In Arthur Vanderbilt's book, Fortune's Children, he notes parties where guests received cigarettes rolled in $100 bills. Or frolicked with toy shovels for diamonds scattered in sand piles on the dining table. These were the castles of the new kings, spawned in an orgy of wealth and power, and visited in the sprawling French chateaus of Newport and Millionaire's Row along New York's Fifth Avenue. The Gilded Age heralded a new American aristocracy. These came not from the genteel plantations of Virginia, but from the burgeoning cities of the East.